गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, आई एम पुष्पांजलि सैनी, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर सेंट जेवियर्स कॉलेज जयपुर। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस जावा स्ट्रिंग्स फ्रॉम कोर जावा प्रोग्रामिंग। सो स्ट्रिंग इज अ सीक्वेंस ऑफ कैरेक्टर्स एंड इन जावा स्ट्रिंग्स आर ट्रीटेड एज द इम्यूटेबल ऑब्जेक्ट्स। देर आर थ्री वेज ऑफ रिप्रेजेंटिंग द स्ट्रिंग्स, यूजिंग द एरेज, यूजिंग द न्यू ऑपरेटर एंड यूजिंग डबल कोट्स। So, in order to do the programming of this string, we have to import java.language.string class, which implements three interfaces: serializable, comparable, and char sequence. Char sequence further implements three classes: string class, string buffer class, and string builder class. We will discuss about these strings first. There are two methods of creating the strings. First is using string literals and second is using new keyword. Using string literals, we have to simply place the value of the string within the double quotes, like string S1 within double quotes, hello Java, this is the value of the string. So if we talk about the string literals, if we are representing the same value with the two different strings, it will not take the different memory allocation. It will hence create the instance of the string, and same memory location will be representing to the both the strings. So in order to avoid this thing, we can create the string using the new operator. With new operator, when we are creating two different strings with same value, the memory will be allocated to both the strings, because here each and every string is treated as the object, but in the string literals, value is treated as the object. So here is the example how we create the strings using literals also and using the new operator also. First is creating a string using literals, giving the value of the string within the double quotes. Second is using the new keyword. We can specify string, declare the string value, that is string 3 is equals to new string value of the string using the new keyword. So these are the two methods with which we can create the strings. Next is various methods associated with the Java strings. First is the comparison methods. In comparison methods, we are having the three different methods. First is using equals method, using double equal to operator, and then is compare to method. When we use the by equals method, in the equals method, it is comparing the equality of the string, value of the string. If it is equal, it will return the true value, otherwise it will return false. For example, if we compare the string S1 and S2 having the same values, it will generate the true output, otherwise it will give the false value if we compare S1 with the S4. Next is using double equal to operator. In the double equal to operator, it will return us true if both the values are same using the literals. But if one value is created using the literal and other is using the new operator, it will return the false. Like all the three strings are having the same value, that is the Sachin. Say S1 and S2 is created using string literals and S3 is created using the new operator. If we compare S1 and S2, it will generate true because its method of creation is same. But if we will compare S1 with S3, although value is same, but it will return false because the method of creation is different in both the cases. Third is compare to method. Compare to methods works on the lexicographically technique in which we compare the values alphabetically and then the outputs are generated. Three rules are being followed here. If S1 is equal to S2, it will return the 0. If S1 is greater than S2, it will return positive value. And if S1 is less than S2, it will return the negative value. So three strings are taken, two are with the same value and third is having the different value. If we compare S1 and S2, the value is same and the S minus it will give us the 0, that's why the value is 0. If we compare S2 minus S3, here S minus R will be giving the positive value. So the according to the positive value, if S1 is greater than S2, it will give us the 1. So if we compare vice versa, that is S3 minus S2 will be done, then it will give us the negative value and the output will be minus 1. Coming to the next method, that is the concatenation method. Concatenation in the Java strings is done by two methods. First is using the plus operator, second is using the concat method. Using the plus operator, we can this way apply first value of the string, plus operator, second value of the string, and it will generate the output as a single string. Second is by using the concat method. In the concat method, first string is being taken, second is taken. How we will write? S1.concat method, and we will pass the value of the second string which we want to concat. This way it will produce the concatenated string. Then we are having various more methods related to the Java strings. Two uppercase method and two lowercase methods. If we want to change the case of the string, in that case we can use the first, we can declare the value of the string using the object of the string s.toUpperCase. It will convert the lowercase values to the uppercase. If we will use s.toLowerCase, it will convert the values to the lowercase. Next method is trim method. Trim method eliminates white spaces before and after the string. If we have specified the string here we had taken the space before string also and taken the space after string also. If we will trim this string, it will generate the output as the such. Then we are having the method start with method and ends with method. In start with method, we have to specify the character from where we want the string to be started. Like we have the value of the string as Sachin. We will start with s.start with SA. It will generate the true output because it is actually starting with SA. If we are asking s.end with N, it will also generate the value N. So next method is caret method. In the caret method, it returns the character at the specified index. So if we have taken the string S is equals to Sachin, s.caret, we have to pass the value of the index is 0. And at the 0 index, the value is S. So here it will return S. And if we will pass the value 3, 0, 1, 2, 3, it will give the output as H. So there are various other methods associated with the Java strings that we will discuss in the next class. Thank you.